How does pea impact on chickpeas? Well, probably in two ways. So the first one is that it has a direct impact on the amount of biomass the crop produces. So that's the above ground growth that we see. So it has a direct impact on the ability of the crop to put bulk on. The other important aspect of it is it actually has an influence on flowering and the number of flowers that the crop can set, which then obviously lead on to producing pods, and then hopefully they fill to produce grains. The older red soils, the old term, the duplex soils that most people would be familiar with, they are inherently low in P. So, because they're inherently low anyway in their native state, but they've been cropped longer than the verticils. So the heavy clay soils, they're in a different bracket. So just with the red soils, you would expect to find P issues with those now. And you should, I would assume that most people would be hopefully applying phosphorus in those circumstances. But if you're in a situation where you're currently not applying P and you don't think you have to apply it, the best way you can find out whether you need it is to go and grow a crop and use it as a bioassay. And by that, I mean you put test strips in. So grab some phosphorus, whether it's a starter product or whatever, and even if you just run a single strip in with your crop and then the balance of your crop, you don't have fertilizer in, you can actually go in there and physically and visually see whether you're getting a response. The simple fact is that if you're growing a crop that's deficient in phosphorus, you're really impacting on the following wheat crop. And you're impacting in a couple of ways. One, you're obviously going to get a reduction in yield on the crop itself. But the fact that it's not operating with adequate phosphorus means that it's not producing enough biomass. And there's a strong link between biomass production and nitrogen fixation. So these legume crops, and you're growing them for obviously to make money, but you're also growing them to fix nitrogen, and you're also growing them as a disease break. And if you're not producing enough biomass, you're robbing yourself of N. You're also denying the crop the opportunity to probably impact on some of the cereal diseases that you're growing them for. So you're getting this knock-on effect in the following cereal crop. So you really need to get your house in order, make sure that your crops are operating at the right nutritional levels to maximise your potential yield under those environmental circumstances you're operating in. And if you get that right, then your whole cropping system can start to hum along.